Corona put a little bit of a damper on some things, but that's okay. We're still getting to talk to some athletes, and today we get to talk to Jalen Beeks via Zoom. So check it out here on this episode of Behind the Lights. How have you guys been?
Pretty good, man. Just been hanging out, you know. What about you guys?
Can't complain. Did Bree tell you we bought an RV?
Did you really?
Yeah, I don't know if I even told her that yet. We're living at it full time.
Oh my gosh, I'm so jealous.
You are?
Yeah, I've been telling Bree to let's get one, and she keeps refusing.
Well, you have a beautiful house, and you're jealous of an RV?
Yeah, on the road, you guys are living it during season and stuff.
Yeah.
That's what I want to do during season.
You're a country boy, Jay. That's why.
I'm not super country, but I have country tendencies.
Well, speaking of country tendencies, I need to know. I've been wondering. I don't know why. I've seen you wear cowboy boots before. Do you wear them with your suits on the road?
I'm not every time, but most, like half the time.
Oh, yeah. I like that. That's funny.
I actually dressed up. I did full suit and boots and a cowboy hat for Bree's birthday this year.
Really? Oh, wait. I saw that with the kids, right?
Yep. We dressed up and cooked her dinner and hung out.
That's a good husband. Good husband award right there.
I try. She liked it, so.
Did you cut your hair?
Bree did.
Really? She did good.
Buzzed it.
I like it.
She usually doesn't let me buzz it.
Well, with quarantine, rules change, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, well, speaking of quarantine, Jay, quarantine and now baseball, where's your head at?
It's on baseball now. For a while during quarantine, I mean, I was working hard, working out, and doing everything, but, you know, you had a little bit of doubt about whether we were coming back. But now I'm full baseball. I feel like it's the middle of the season, and I'm ready to go.
What'd your workouts look like during, you know, off-season 2.0?
Well, we went out, since we got back, we went out and bought dumbbells and a bench and just a couple of little things so I could work house. And then I do as much as I can with what I got. So with 90-pound dumbbells, just work out every day and throwing long tossing, throwing bullpens. I was pretty lucky, but pretty blessed to have a lot of minor league college guys and a couple big league guys where we live. So they were all wanting to work out too, so it worked out.
So do you go back to where you went to school?
Yes.
That's nice. So your first summer home in Arkansas in years, did you pick up any new hobbies?
Other than landscaping and yeah, you know, just working on the yard. I never had a yard before, so it's nice. Learning a lot of new things about grass, things like that. So, like, old man things.
But, please, you know, tell me what you learned about grass.
Oh, just like, you know, summer grass and winter grass and when to sprig and when to seed and all this. It was fun. Bree helped me out. I had a general idea, but, you know, it's a lot more complicated than it sounds.
Another project you had was a swing set. How'd that go?
It took a long time. It did. But you know what? That's what quarantine was for. Do stuff that, you know, takes 3 days. It took 3 days, me and Bree working on it. But we got it done.
Jeez. Well, Jay, what's your diet look like? Organic or eat whatever you want kind of guy?
Organic when I can, I guess. You know, you don't always have the option, especially going through the minors. Like, you got what you got. But I try to eat healthy and take care of my body and, you know, meat, fruits and vegetables. I don't even eat brown rice and bread and stuff like that.
Does Bree help out with that?
She does. She is fantastic. Whatever I need, she has always been on board. So it's been really, really awesome having her as a wife throughout just my career.
All right, well, Ty had a question for you. It's a really good one. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
It's memorable, and it's probably the most creative interview question I've ever had. Did you ever collect Beanie Babies as a kid?
Collect Beanie Babies. I had Beanie Babies.
Still?
I don't know.
Or you had?
No. I used to have Beanie Babies, but it's been a while. So I guess you can call me a small collector of Beanie Babies.
All right. What about the kids? Do they have any? Is that still a thing?
They do not have any. Yeah, I haven't seen a Beanie Baby in years. That's an interesting question from Ty, which I appreciate the question. We are so minimalistic with how we travel that we do not have Beanie Babies at this moment.
All right, well, minimalistic and traveling, I mean, traveling with two kids, that's got to be hard. What's it like having the kids and Bree on the road with you in the hotel room, before you're going to pitch?
Yeah, I mean, it's always better when they're there, and just period. Obviously things change. Like, my routine changes a little bit when they're with me, like when I'm at home or when they're with me on the road. My routine's a little different, but it's always a positive. And I love having them there. But we just, more active. I don't sit in a coffee shop waiting for the field to open up. They like to go do stuff, so.
What about sleep? Do you sleep all right when they're there?
Yeah, I mean, not as much, but, still fine. Good thing about them is they're on baseball schedule, so they like to sleep in most of the time. So usually, if it's not a big time change, it's not too big of a deal, but it can be a big deal if we're coming from a bad time change, because when they're waking up 3 hours earlier, that ain't fun.
Do you just wear it then? You feel tired?
Bree's awesome. Yeah, again, Bree's awesome. If I'm starting that day, she probably takes over and lets me sleep. But if not, we just both get up and hang out.
Now, you've kind of played both the reliever and starter role. What's the difference in routine there?
I don't even know what bulk is. It's a reliever technically, but it's scheduled and it's, I don't know. It's different. I've done a lot of different things. Less for straight relieving. You just gotta go with the flow depending on how your body feels that day. If I want to work out the day, I'll go work out. If I don't, if my body's not feeling great, I just won't. Or maybe a rehab day if I'm not feeling great. But then starting, it's just very day one I'm doing this, day two I'm doing this, day three I'm doing this. So they're very different, and just you gotta be more flexible as a reliever.
Now, I know some guys hate to get this question, but I know the fans would kill me if I didn't ask. Do you have a role that you prefer?
That I prefer? No, not really. They both have. I'm pretty lucky to have done both, and actually see a lot of guys just do one. But they both got their benefits. I guess coming in a tight game as a reliever is pretty awesome, but then starting a game against a big time opponent in a big time environment, and you get to be out there for 5 or 6 innings, that's awesome. So they both have their perks. But I'm good. Let me play baseball as long as possible.
That's what Ty says. Whoever's paying the bills, whatever job it is, doesn't matter.
Yep.
All right, well, Jay, I got a fan question for you. What's something you do on a consistent basis that you feel helps you play your best game?
I would say there's just one thing, because there's just so many different aspects of pitching and being ready for the game every day. I think my routine just gets me in a comfortable spot, just stick me in my routine, which, starts pretty much at the beginning. I'm very step-by-step person, so I read my Bible and pray every morning, and that just gets me in the right mindset going forward for the rest of the day. And just working out and throwing the exact way I should on that day, getting mentally prepared. I enjoy listening to music right before I go out, something that's soothing, it relaxes me so I can, just pitch my best without thinking too much. There's a bunch of things like that I can go on and on, but just sticking to my routine, I guess, would be the one thing.
All right, well, I want to know, what kind of music keeps you calm before pitching in front of thousands of people?
Yeah, so I listen to usually worship music or, you know, some 80s country.
Yeah.
Honestly, George Strait. I'm a big George Strait fan. Alan Jackson, George Jones, that era is probably my favorite. And that kind of relaxes me because I just think about the music for a minute and just take my mind off of what's going on, what I'm about to go do, and then just kind of refocuses me.
Do you have a walkout song?
Like, I do. Where I Belong by Building 429 is just a Christian song. Just I like it. Puts me in the right perspective of that, you know, not having a temporary perspective, but eternal, like what's going to happen tomorrow, the next day, 100 years.
Well, that's cool, Jay, because a lot of guys, you know, try and hype themselves up with the rap music, so it's cool to hear you kind of like the slowing down version of that, really. Yeah. Jay, you did spend a lot of years in the minor leagues. Worst experience there?
Worst experience in the minor leagues? I mean, there wasn't any just like absolutely terrible experiences, but there was like no good ones either. So it was just, you were just there. And that was the thing about the minor leagues. You were just there. That's what made it so tough, is that it just, you know, you're getting to play baseball, which was awesome, but after that, everything else was not that fun. I wouldn't say there's one. I can't think of one moment that just stands out, but it's just a constant beat down.
All right, let me reiterate then. What about worst minor league city?
I did not like playing in Lowell, Massachusetts.
Yeah.
Did not enjoy that. You know, usually on the road, it was fine. Just because we were staying in a hotel, but when you had to find an apartment or something, it wasn't always pretty. Like Salem, I liked playing in Salem, but like the city was not good.
Right.
You remember Salem?
Yeah.
It wasn't great. And that's actually where my daughter was born. You know, little fun fact. And we're probably never going back.
Right, that's a fun fact for her to be able to say. I was born in Salem. That's funny. Yep. I remember Bree telling me that, and she had to like find a random wife to take her to the hospital because, you know, the show goes on with you guys.
Absolutely. I mean, they gave me 48 hours after she was born. I started that 3 days after she was born.
Wow. Well, I mean, at least Bree was there, I guess, in the same city, so you didn't have to travel, but it's definitely not easy. But, Jay, a lot of guys play card games on the flights. What do you do?
So I like playing card games, just whatever we're doing. I like hanging out. I'm not very good at sleeping on the flights, so I'm walking around or doing something, or, you know, it's pretty cool. They got some good food. You know, music is blaring at all times, so that might be why I can't sleep. But there's, you know, there's poker games going on and just, you know, pitch and all pluck and all sorts of card games. So we play a lot of cards, a lot of downtime.
What's your favorite card game?
I like spades. I like suit catching games like that. Spades, pluck, cards. But I do enjoy watching some guys playing poker. They play poker every time. And they get into it.
All right, Jay, best dad joke.
Best dad joke. man, I don't have a dad. I have dad responses. So I talk like a dad, and when I do kid around, it's pure dad jokes, and everybody says I'm a dad. I don't know if I have just a straight up dad joke, but it is very obvious that I am a dad.
All right.
When I speak.
That's fair. Well, you know, I'll give you a break on that one, but figure out one to keep in your pocket because they always come handy.
I know, I need one.
But worst kid's song, like, that gets stuck in your head?
Oh, there's so many. Baby Shark.
Yep.
That was terrible. and my kids absolutely love that song. Wheels on the Bus, not a fan.
Really?
My son, for about 2 years, no, I guess year and a half, he made me sing that every night before he went to bed.
Can I hear it?
I don't like it anymore. No, you can't.
No? All right. No. Fine. No,
just for my son, no shot.
I'll get Bree to send me footage, though. So.
Yeah, okay, there you go. You can ask her. It's real.
All right, Jay. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk with me over Zoom. Best of luck with things post-corona. For people that want to keep up with you, I know you're not huge on Instagram, but where can they find you?
So I kind of am on Instagram, and I'm trying to be on Twitter. I'm trying to be socially relevant with Bree's help. So maybe in the future, I can get that going a little bit.
All right.
That's the plan.
All right, so what's your Instagram handle?
I don't know.
Let me look real quick, just so everybody knows.
You ain't looking for me. I'm trying, but, you know.
You got three pictures.
I even got one.
Yeah, you got three pictures. That's all we got. Let me see.
Well, I used to have zero, so we are working forwards.
It's just straight up Jalen Beeks. How did you not know that?
That.
Come on, Jay.
That. Well, I didn't know if there was going to be like a... one in there, I can't remember.
All right, well, thanks for your time, Jay. Good luck with whatever the season may hold, if there is one.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on.
Thanks. Bye, Jay.
Bye-bye.